morning, good afternoon, and good evening, guys. Celtic Warband here, and thanks for tuning in to another episode in my Agamemnon campaign for Total War Saga Troy. And apologies that it has been quite a few days since the last uploads in Total War Saga Troy, but I've just been a little busy in my personal life and I haven't had a chance until now. But they should be back to full swing, so we should have two uploads every week from here on out. So let's go ahead and dive on in. Now, from what I can remember in the last episode, Agamemnon managed to take the Ionian city, but I believe that we're still at war with the Ionians. If we take a look, I don't think they have any territory left, though. No, they're a horde faction, so they've got a very tiny army somewhere, but I don't think that it's going to cause us any threat. And if we look at the map as it stands here, we're kind of up here. Most of these people are friendly with us because they're of the Greek culture, but we've got more Ionians to deal with, and I'm kind of eyeing Athens right now. Now, they are stronger than us, but they've got five settlements, so that could be very useful for us to get. They've got this one here, which is the main settlement capital of this province, and Salamis is actually, I believe, a vassal of mine, so having that would still be okay for us because we could obviously confederate later on and grab the rest of that province for myself. But they've also got Athens and I think three other cities over here, so we could get a full province just by going to war with them. And it is a little bit risky, but I might actually try and call my allies in as reinforcements, and we should be just fine. Because if we look at the relation as far as the attitude focus goes, of course the Trojan factions all hate us, and we're at war with all of them, but Athens is the very next one after that. So, and I don't think we can get peace with any of these factions. They're all deteriorating, so yeah, they're not going to take peace, which is unfortunate, because I don't really have any plans to go after them for a little while, but that is fine. So let's go ahead and start our conquest of Athens and hope that nobody backstabs us as we bring our army down south. Now, we just conquered this, so I would like to get maybe some walls in here first off before we do move on. Also, Pylos here. Do they only have one region?
I am happy to...
No, they've got three regions. Okay, so yeah, we probably don't want to go after them either because they're pretty friendly with us. So we'll just leave them alone for now. But yeah, we've got the main settlement building. We don't have the other three. So that could cause us some problems as far as public order goes, or the happiness of the province. But we'll see how it goes because our Achaean influence is not going to be the best compared to what else is here. Although actually it is going up. So that is good. The Ionian influence is going down quite dramatically. So that is good. Yeah, so maybe we actually will be able to hold on to this just fine. Let's take a look at our other territories, because it has been a little while since I played this. We're lacking some stone at the moment, and I was hoping to get that chariot building built. Where did I build that at? Did I build it at Mycenae itself? I've got a watchtower at Corinth, which is a... Where the heck is Corinth at? Where are you? Oh yeah, you're over here. Okay, so I probably did that because I was worried about Athens. So yeah, having those in there wouldn't be the worst shout in the world. I thought I was building a chariot building though. Or maybe I'm just blind. Is this it right here and I'm just stupid? Yeah, this is the building right here. Okay, perfect. So maybe we'll actually try and grab some chariots too. Now, do they cost any bronze? They do not. They only cost 160 food. The reinforced chariots cost some bronze, but I've heard that they're actually pretty useful to have in the army. So yeah, we'll move Agamemnon's army down next turn because I think we just conquered Aegeon in the last episode at the very end. Is there anything else that I can do? I can request some stuff from my allies. I could request some stone, maybe. Get a bit of extra stone from them. That is useful. And they should still be improving. Yes, I can't request it from them, though, unfortunately. Or maybe it does it all together. That could be correct. That maybe the more vassals that I have, the more I can actually request from them. But now, does that mean that I can build something here? Surely there's something that can be built up. I would like to get this up to level 4 to get the reinforced chariots. Do we have enough growth for that? We've got 3 population surplus. We need one more. Okay, we need 580. The Grand Citadel, but maybe we... Should we upgrade that before our capital itself is upgraded? I'm not 100% sure. But I don't think it matters too much. I would also like to confederate with this vassal here because I just really want that extra food. It's a farming city. So yeah, having the extra food there would be super useful, but I think he still isn't interested in a confederation. Which is fine. He's serving me well enough as a vassal as it is. So let's go ahead and end the turn. And we'll just fast forward here. Peace treaty with you guys. What? No, not a chance. Non-aggression pact with who? Athens? Is this Athens? Yeah, that's hilarious. No. They know I'm coming for them, that's why. Blighted crops. Oh dear. The gods are showing their displeasure with your farmers by sending a mysterious plague that ravages their harvest. Reparations have been made to the gods, but there is no saving the current crops. What should we do? So we could harvest early. That would give us -5% to all resources and -1 happiness, or burn the blighted crops. -20% food per turn from buildings in this province. But that's only 4 turns. This is 6 turns. Let's just try and get it over with, I think. Is that going to put us in the negative? No, we're still okay. Poseidon's anger grows. I'm assuming... Oh, is that the last of the Ionian troops there? Perfect. We could actually just get rid of them right now. Mycenae. And we could just auto-resolve that.
Take them down!
Oh, right to the face. Oh my goodness. Settle down there, big boy. Yeah, I'll take the replenishment.
Enslave the captives. Forward march.
So does that mean that they are dead? Ancillary gain, +2 motivation, the bronze diploma. Enemy killed in battle. And faction destroyed.
Remember
perfect.
This day.
That is perfect. Okay, so we've got the port here, which is good. Happiness is -6, so maybe we should get a happiness building in there. I would like to get the guardhouse in, but we actually can't until it goes up to level 2. So, is there anything that gives us growth? The mudbrick houses do. And the food warehouses. Can't get any of that until level 2. And then we've got the special buildings we can throw in as well. So let's go for growth? Because that's only gonna give us extra 3 happiness, so it's not gonna save us in the long run. So yeah, let's go for the mudbrick houses there. Let's bring this army down south. You are going to be very valuable in giving me intel on the Athenians. And we can upgrade this port, or we can upgrade to get the renowned slingers. Do we have any slingers in the army? We do, so we could... We could swap them out, but they cost bronze. We do have a pretty good surplus of bronze, to be honest. But if there's anything... Yeah, get that extra food and resources, because I would like to actually push out another army. So if we can go for that, and then... Is there anything here that we need? Doesn't look like it. As far as our missions go... Recruit the hero... I guess this in a settlement that you own. So we might actually do that right before we go to war with Athens. Recruit a mythical unit. Accumulate 250 favor with any god. And we have to capture the following regions. That's going to be tough. Argos. And Theria. Yeah, that's going to be difficult to do. Argos was kind of thinking about confederation. Like, they're more interested in confederation than my vassal is. 51. What could I offer them? Oh, no. Don't do that. Yeah, I can't, like, sweeten the deal or anything to make it more in our favor for that. And they're pretty friendly with us, so we're just gonna have to wait for that. Now, as far as the gods go, 250 favor with any god. Oh, yes, that's gonna take us quite a bit. Don't we have a... Yeah, Sanctuary of Apollo going up, so that should increase our favor. I'm not sure if that's per turn, though. We might have to look into that if it requires any more missions. And then Royal Decrees, we're getting +3 to influence faction-wide, which is good. And then we should probably go for the extra wood, I'm thinking. Or the extra happiness would also be pretty good. Yeah, so we'll take a look at that next turn. I think that's everything we can do, though, so let's go ahead and end the turn once again. What is this? Military alliance with Argos. No, because it's going to make you stronger, and I want to confederate with you. Also, I don't want to be drawn into your wars, so sorry. Military access. You want 1,000. You're neutral. No. My ally has been attacked. Defender is Ithaca. Attacker is Ellis. Where are you on the map? You're up there, and defender is Ithaca up there. Oh, okay, that might change our plans then. We might have to go up there. We've actually got 2 territories over there. Let's enter the war on the side of my ally. Poseidon's Bounty. Fishermen from your coastal settlements report an exceptional bounty this year, having nearly doubled their usual catch. You must ensure this gift from Poseidon does not go to waste, so feed the fishermen. Campaign movement range at sea and influence faction-wide, or distribute the fish. Extra. I mean, we've got enough of that, so let's go for the extra influence, because we've got a really good surplus of food. Level up with Apollo. Excellent. Oh, what? Oh, okay, that's fine. Faction destroyed. So, they're up here. Now, are they at war with a ton of people now? Yeah, actually, I think they're going to be kept rather busy. So we'll just leave that for now. I doubt that they're going to come over here and cause us any problems. Let's get you down. So you need to get over into this territory to get a couple of chariots. Now, what are we going to drop? Because we've got the shielded clubmen here, and we've got some club warriors. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think I'm going to get rid of these light swordsmen. So we got 5 of them. We're going to get maybe 5 of them, and then 2 chariots could be good. So let's disband those. Get 2 of the shielded clubmen. And then when we have access to swap them out, we will... Or sorry, when we have access to the chariots, we'll hire them, which should be actually in the next turn. Excellent, excellent. What else do we want over here? Could get the logger's tent, just to get even more of the logs, more resources, or we could put in walls, but I'm feeling pretty safe at the moment. And that's up there, so I don't think I'm going to be declared war on anytime soon, so yeah, let's... Because over here, we've already got those 2 covered. We've got a chariot building close by, we don't need that. You've already got the light swordsman building. So, yeah, I think let's just get extra logs. I think that's a perfect idea. Also, 100 food per turn faction-wide, that could be very useful. But let's go for the happiness. Try and make sure that we don't have any rebellions. And you can level up. Influence over this province. Our influence, pretty solid so far. But I don't know if we really need that, to be honest. We'll leave it as is for now. And over here, you're still building that, which is perfect. Very good. I don't think there's anything else I need to do. Just blasting through unturns here. I would like to get a battle. I'm hoping we could get a battle against Athens in this episode. You want a single barter. What do we have with you guys? Oh, he's giving us a gift. Non-aggression pact, military access. Yeah, let's change this and see if we can get some stuff out of him. Oh, he has zero stone. Seriously. Can I get? Would he give me like 100 bronze? He would. Oops. Okay, so 150 is too much, 140 is too much. Yeah, alright, there you go. That's fair. Give me some of that bronze. She keeps hitting my priest over here.
I read the omen.
Prophecy of Doom, 35%. Yeah, it's not gonna happen. So yeah, let's just scout out and see where Athens' armies are. So they've got two there, so they're slowly
this
building up.
Important.
Don't see any armies nearby. So that's Marathon, Thoracos. And that's down there. So that's their five settlements? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? They have five settlements.
We're not starting from a...
Do they have a lot of allies? Is that what factors into their... No, they don't have any military allies and they have one defensive ally, but we could just join the war through the Arcadians and get some stuff out of it. So where are their supposed armies around here? That's weird.
Portents are no mystery to me.
Maybe they're hidden over here and I just can't see it. But they're supposedly a lot stronger than us, so... That's a 15-stack garrison there. Whew. 5 at Thoracos. That would be a soft spot to hit. Or we could come all the way down here. Start here and then work our way up, but... You know, we might just have to go for the heavy hitter first. Start sieging it down. The charioteers might not be... super useful as well for siege battles, but if we can force them out, maybe. We've also got 183, so 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, 120, so we'd still be positive if we put that in, but I would like to get another army going up. Yes, here we go, charioteers.
As you suggest.
And is that... Well, I can actually fit 3 of them in there. Oh, I actually quite like that. 3 charioteers going in. Excellent. And then... Let's hire this guy that we had to hire. I'm hoping we won't go negative, but we may. Aegisthus, I hope is how you pronounce it. Where is he? He's all the way at the bottom. This guy here, right?
A natural progression.
Put him in. We're still pretty positive. If we just get a bunch of cheap and cheerful things... Like, that's only 99 there. Or light swordsman, 106. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Could get 5 of them, but we might just have to go cheap and cheerful with this. Could get some more slingers, which would definitely be useful.
Understood.
Yeah, so if we get 6 slingers, that's 600. And then just fill it with a bunch of militia for the rest. I think that could be good, and then we'll be ready to go. Leveling that up, extra experience for all units, plus 120% line of sight. No, we'll wait for now. Because we're going to have some pretty big upgrades coming soon here, which we're going to need stuff for. Yeah, actually, we'll be able to upgrade that next turn, so that's good. So yeah, let's just save our money then. Excellent. So we'll bring him over here on the next turn, and he won't be fully prepared, but we'll probably just continue building up his army. But we'll declare war on Athens very, very soon. Just have to pick the right moment. No. Go away. You don't need my military access. You're not even at war with anyone near me. Failure, that's good. Where are the Athenian armies? Listen.
Out into the world. I pray for safe passage.
There's like nobody around.
The omens are good.
That's very strange. Okay, well, we'll come back up here then. Let's get... Oh, what? Where did all our food go? We might not be able to get as many as I thought.
As you say.
Get some infantry there.
Gold rich.
You can move over to here. Is there anyone that will give us some barter agreements here? These guys are pretty friendly.
King Agamemnon's words have weight.
Could give them a defensive alliance and a single barter. No, actually, let's see if we can get like something for a few turns. So like 200. Oh yeah, they'll do that for sure, actually. Oh, they got a lot of food. This could actually work out well for me. They can pay for like 8 of my units. Boom, for 5 turns. Thank you.
This works.
Oh yeah, exit that. You are not the friendliest, but we just discovered you.
Let's hear
it. Oh,
again.
Yeah, you don't want to do anything. You don't want any agreements. Knossos, I don't want to enter into any more agreements with them because we actually need their territory. And they're actually quite weak. Ooh, we could actually go after them. They're just a really far distance away. That would be really hard to defend all of this island here. Who else do we have on here, too? Who else is that? I don't know who this is, but I can't select them. Probably we've not discovered them yet. Alright, so yeah, that has helped our food situation for now, and Agamemnon has leveled up once again. Let's see, what else... Think we got this now. Hero now gains rage passively. Oh, okay. Or gives this hero missile attack. Or bloodthirst. I think because we sent him into melee, we should get bloodthirst. Or we haven't actually unlocked quite a few of these. So, protector of the people, 8 morale. Plus 20% of movement range of hero's army after battle. Oh. Increases success chance of stealing spoils from fallen heroes. We could go minus to the attrition, extra raiding income, and hit points. Casualty replenishment and raiding. Raiding no longer incurs movement penalties. Rallying cry. So I kind of like this raiding one. So let's get that. Do we have any others that we can grab? I think we do. So if we... Because that's charge bonus for all units. Two-handed weapons or shielded infantry units. We have a lot of shielded infantry units. So yeah, probably get that. And plus 20% to battle captives taken. Or influence after victory, doubled if battle captives are killed. Okay, let's do... Oh man, I don't know what to choose. Income from sacking, we're not really going to do too much of that. Disciplinarian, so we could get extra casualty when raiding, or doesn't incur movement. So we could push it to the maximum of our movement and then use it? Use raiding stance? I think extra battle captives, so we'll go for that. This affects allies in range. So let's go for that too. Yeah, now we need to choose shield wall. Or extra morale and melee defense. I think we're going to be fairly aggressive with his army, so let's go for Rally and Cry. And that is it. So actually, we had quite a few levels to put on him there. So he should be quite a bit more beefy now, which is excellent. So if we look in raiding now, required to adopt 50%. So I don't really get that. We should be able to raid right now. We move. But apparently not. Maybe it takes effect next turn. I could be wrong about that. Good. Oh, man. So I think we're pretty set to push on Athens very soon here. Let's go ahead and end another turn. Got the Spartan armies all over the map. He is a pretty strong boy when he starts. Menelaus. Get out of here. Epic mission issued. Assign the hero adjacent to office in the King Men mechanic. Oh, okay. Let's see. He can't go into that. Yeah, he can't go into that. Where is this Krathon guy? Did I hire someone that I didn't realize, or? Oh, no. It's only an 8 stack. They have a giant vanguard. Oh, boy. I only have 6 there, though. Shoot. Danann host gathers. It is obvious that the Great Achaean Kings, that the Trojans refuse to listen to reason. All-out war is inevitable at this point, so the major question concerns where exactly you stand. Faction marked as Pillars of the Danans. Declare no support, decide later. We'll just support them. Okay, yeah, that's a problem.
We will claim victory.
They are probably going to be pushing over here. Why are they not being dealt with? That's what I want to know. Why are you guys not taking them out? Did you take out their other territory? Yeah, you must have, because are they just down
to
one now?
Does Agamemnon really want to negotiate?
Yeah, they're at war with everyone, and they're very weak. I think that is their last army there. Okay. But he's not going to make it up there in time. The question is, will I be able to hold that back? Shielded spearmen, too. Do we would have walls here, I would assume. Don't know if I want to try and level that up just yet, and I don't know if I want to send this army north.
Expert archer.
Because then he could turn around and hit me and I would get wrecked, I think. Let's bring him up here, I guess. What's this guy's range?
That will never work.
He's in force march, so I don't know how far he could get. Probably not too far.
War makes the man.
So if I bring him here...
I pledge my loyalty.
Ooh, this guy... Oh, okay, I thought that was the loyalty. I was like, only two, that is not good. Let's do that. Let's try and get some...
I will do so.
More infantry there. Meanwhile, we're going to hit this territory here. I still don't see any major Athenian armies in the area.
Hermes is with me. I will call down divine disfavor. I will.
Oh no! She was wounded. Critical failure. That sucks. Okay, so let's join the war through this faction here.
I expect a profitable meeting.
I will join against Athens. They will be happy with that, but then they're going to have to pay for my troops for a while. Oh, they don't have a lot of food. How are they going to pay for this, I wonder? $200, because I think that's all they can afford. And how about you give me 100 bronze? No, they're like, forget it. How about 100 stone? No. 100 wood? Alright, let's just pay for 3 of my units. And that should be fine. For 5 turns.
No hesitate.
Easy as that. And that means we are ready to go. So let's push in against Megara. Maybe they'll sally out. I'm not 100% sure.
Victory awaits us.
Grab some siege equipment. We're going to need it. Okay, so they've got heavy sword skirmishers, which we've dealt with before. Island Club Warriors. Light Spearmen. They don't have a lot of archers, though. And my slingers should do a pretty good amount of damage. Now, are these guys skirmishers? No, they're not. But they might be really good at charging through choke points once we get in. So let's go ahead and continue the siege there. They should actually start to take attrition as well. So we might not actually have a battle in this episode, guys. Well, unless we have a battle against these guys here. But we will have the fight beginning with Athens on the battlefield in the next episode. Extra happiness would be good. I don't really care about that building. Oh, Mycenae, what can you guys build? Can get... Yeah, that upgraded to the renowned skirmishers. Or we could go for that building there. We could also do that. So I guess that's fine. And the lighthouse... Sure. I feel like that should be only present in, like, port settlements, though. So that's kind of weird. Although, I guess it's watchtower patrols, so... That makes sense. Yeah, what I should have done is to build a guardhouse here. I really didn't think they were going to aggressively push in like that. Damn. But let's see, if they just siege me and not push the attack, I can at least push in with these guys. And then bring them in as reinforcements. Peace treaty with them for... Oh, they're offering that. Really? Interesting. I guess I could take that, but I'm not sure if the other factions would be super happy with that. Although it's only me and my vassals, actually, so if I peace out with them, they might also peace out with them too. So let's go ahead and agree to that. And yes, I saw that they're at peace with all of us, so that works out. Non-aggression pact, and they're offering 500. Sure. Is that pretty balanced? We could get some military access out of that. Or maybe not. Does that actually give us a better deal? It does. Okay, that's too much. So what if we do like 580? 560 would. Okay, so he went into siege, but he's not pushing in. Settlement besieged. Hostile activity. Yes, yes. We've got 10, though. So what do they have if I push out? Oh, yeah, there's like... Oh, they've got 2 giant vanguards. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. They don't have a lot of armor, though. Damage is 200. Ooh. I would like to... Will we be okay with that? Would like to maybe get a couple more slingers if possible. Can I still get slingers here? No, I cannot.
Setting out.
Let's risk it. I would like to get a couple more slingers.
Yes.
Just because of those big infantry. I don't know if he'll be able to win if we have the walls, because our towers should do a lot of damage to them. So let's just hope.
Strike hard and true.
Yeah, it's not very even. They've got their defender companion here. Battering rams, yeah, just keep building them.
Total destruction!
Total destruction. Yes. Oh. Here is their army. Okay, so let's see if we could get is Salamis at war with Athenia? 57. Oh. Maybe I should have just declared war on them and called in my allies. Uh-oh. That could be bad. That could be bad, especially if they decide to come over here, because I can hit that in one turn.
Show no mercy.
So that's where their main army is. And we've got Hector over here, too. Oh, boy. Hector, what are you doing over here, buddy? Maybe we can't afford to wait. Maybe we should just push in. Although, I'm holding this for what reason? Should I even be bothering to hold that? Could just let it go. It's really not making me a lot of money. I think that's what I might have to do. We can always go back and conquer it later.
We will claim victory.
So let's move down this direction. No, we shouldn't abandon it. Yeah, I think we should be fine down there with Agamemnon. We've got a lot of enemies, though, so maybe we should pull back and see where they land.
Orphan their offspring.
You ask
Slight Spearsman, Sword Skirmishers, he's got some bows. Because if we can break their army in the field... Also, I've got to be wary of Hector's force over here. But we've got Argos. Let's see if they can get rid of Hector for me.
For glory.
Yeah, because they're at war with him. Also, you over here. Yeah, you need to do some work. Go after Hector, and then... Yeah, they can't come on land over here, so they could come over here and siege. That would be bad. We would lose that, which would be really unfortunate. But let's level up this to level 4. And... the influence building, I think I'm going to destroy. I don't really need it there anymore, but I'm a little worried about this here. So let's do one more end turn. Nope. Sparta's been attacked by these guys. We'll enter on the side of our ally. Okay, so what are they doing? Where did their army go? Oh no! Oh wait, they came back towards us here! Oh, so they pulled off the attack. I'm not gonna win that with what I have, I don't think. So let's retreat, hope he doesn't push on. That means we're going to lose the progress of our slingers, though. Yeah, so we lost the progress of our slingers. But it means that we gained a bit of extra time.
Forward as one.
So we come here. Try and get our three more slingers again. Where did their army go off to? The Athenian army. Hector is there. You guys need to need to hit Hector there. You guys as well.
I'll do it right.
How many more turns till they take attrition? One more turn till they run out of supplies. Okay, there's no army over here as of yet, which is good. Maybe I should try and build some walls there. Just to be safe, but we've got a lot of allies around us. Okay, let's get rid of that. We don't need that building anymore. We can get something better in there.
Victory beckons.
Yeah, if they don't turn around and go in there, then we should be able to hit them next turn, and then we'll actually have two battles in the next episode. Apologies, guys. I really just want to make sure this is set up here, and since we're already blasting through turns, we might as well just continue, but I'm very wary of that giant vanguard. Like, they've got it. They've got a lot of health. They don't have much armor, though, so that's why I'm hoping my slingers will just be able to focus them down early on. I should have actually set some of my allies to go after them. Oh, crap. Oh, no. Oh, so they've come out here. Okay, retreat, Agamemnon. No! Oh, my gosh, no! Oh, no! Okay, that's not the worst thing in the world. We've got some pretty good troops here. Their armor is 70? Heavy sword skirmishers. It's a lot of light spearmen. And they do have two heroes. I think we'll be okay with the chariots. I think we'll be okay. But we're going to open the next episode fighting this battle. I pray that we do not lose Agamemnon this way. I thought that we would be able to just move into Athens without too much trouble, but they have brought all of their armies back and are striking at him in full force. But thanks so much for watching, guys. I really hope you enjoyed. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe if you'd like to see more content like this in the future, and I will see you in the next one.